if you want to be a treatment-free beekeeper, there's a huge, huge catch that you have to know about before you start. And it is that if you only start out with two or three colonies and you go treatment-free, you're probably going to have no bees at the end, and you're going to have to either give up or start over. And the reason for that is this. So there's a beekeeper with a whole bunch of colonies who decides to quit treating for mites. Well, all of his bees have mites, because when you have bees, you have mites. But some of those bees are better at dealing with the varroa than others, and they can kind of deal with mites to a certain extent without human help. Some of the mites in those colonies are more lethal than others for whatever reason. Maybe they're better at reproducing. And some of the viruses in those mites that those mites are injecting into some of those bees might be more lethal than others. When that beekeeper stops treating, what happens is the bees that can't handle the mites in any way, shape, or form die, and they leave the gene pool. Then the mites that are more lethal to the bees kill the bees that are their hosts, and then they have nothing left to eat, so they die too. So what happens after a few years of this is you're left with a population of bees and a population of mites that can coexist. Bob Binnie did this. Check out his channel. He made a living beekeeping for himself and for many employees for decades, and he really knows a lot of stuff. He tried this for 7 years in 3 of his bee yards. He lost 50% of his colonies the first year, 80% the second year, and got slowly better every year after that. And all these yards were far away from other beekeepers, but at the end of the 7 years, somebody else moved in next door with like 500 colonies, and the genetics mixed, so all that progress was lost because there was crossover between the genes, and then the queens, you know, they go out and they mate in the air, so they were mating with drones from the other beekeeper. You have to be isolated and you have to have a lot of colonies. So think about it, 80%, 50%, you know, and that's like 80% of the 50% that were left.
If you don't want chemicals in your honey, you can still control your mites without chemicals. You can control your mites with powdered sugar. You can control your mites with brood breaks. You can control your mites with drone trapping. But if you only have 2 or 3 colonies and you want some of them to stay alive, then you probably have to do something. To know for sure if you have to do something, check your mite levels. Opening up your colony and looking at your bees to see if there's mites on them is not checking your mite levels, because the mites hide on the bees. You can't see them. To see the mites and count them, you have to get them off the bees. I'm going to show you a kind and gentle and easy way to get the mites off the bees so that you can count them and figure out what your mite levels are.
All you really need to check your mite levels is some screen with 1/8 inch holes, something to cut the screen with, either tin snips or a utility knife. Powdered sugar, a cup of water, and a jar with the ring. Forgot to mention, you also need some newspaper. If you are using a jar that does not have these measuring lines on it, that's fine. But measure out 1/2 cup of something, and then draw a line with a permanent marker so that you know where the 1/2 cup mark is, because we're going to put 1/2 cup of bees in here. It's best to do this on a beautiful sunny day when most of your older, grouchier bees are out grocery shopping in the flowers. It's also best to use your smoker to distract them from the big, huge person that's opening up their roof and taking their frames out. Have your lid off. Honey looks like this. Capped worker brood looks like that. Capped drone brood looks like this. It's a lot taller and bumpier. And see the holes in the middle? That has eggs and larvae. If you see the queen, avoid scooping her up. And if you don't see the queen, then don't worry about it. Like this, if you can find a big clump of them, then that makes them very easy to scoop. There we go. All those bees that are flying, those are not nurse bees. Those are foragers. Nurse bees are too young to know how to fly. They're the ones that you want for your test, because they're the ones where you're going to find all the varroa mites. So now take your newspaper and you can dump them in, shake them in. You can also scoop them in if you prefer, like this. Give them a thump on something and check if they're at your half a cup mark. Mine are just over a half a cup, so that's fine. Remember to put your lid on because otherwise they'll escape. So here's your half a cup of bees. Here's your powdered sugar. Get some powdered sugar on your hive tool. Dump it in on top of the bees. At least a tablespoon. And just let it sift down. Like that. And then roll your bees around. Like this. This method of checking for mites is called a sugar roll. Now I'm going to dump this sugar in a cup of water and count my mites. Okay, here's my cup of water, and I'm going to shake the sugar out of here with the bees still in here, just like it's a salt shaker. Just like this. If you see more than one or two mites in a sugar shake of half a cup of bees, you have a problem and you need to do something about it. Because by the time they get really, really sick to where you can see their problem, it'll be too late.
Correction, it's never too late until they're actually dead. But if the population has already crashed and they're already in their death spiral, it's not enough to just kill your mites, because your bees are already sick with the viruses that the mites injected into them. So you'll have a bunch of dead mites and a bunch of dying bees if you treat at that point. What you need to do is kill your mites, of course, but also give your bees at least one frame of healthy capped brood that is about to hatch out and be healthy adult bees. And maybe depending how late it is in the year and how bad the situation is, you might want to give them more than one frame of capped brood. And you'll want to give them some healthy nurse bees on that brood. So you'll have to find a healthy colony either from another colony that you have or from another beekeeper that has his mites under control. And if you do that, I've done that before for a friend that had 60 mites in a sugar roll. of 300 bees, half a cup of bees, and it worked. If you do that, you will be okay. But that's a lot of extra effort, so it's better to take care of it when you don't have too many mites.
You can see most of the powdered sugar has dissolved, and if there were any varroa mites in there, you'd be able to count them. But this colony clearly does not have a problem.